Action Africa Help Zambia is a country program of Action Africa Help International, AAHI, an African-led not-for-profit humanitarian and development agency based in Nairobi, Kenya, that supports livelihood-challenged communities to sustainably improve their well-being and standard of living. With other country programs in South Sudan, Somalia, and Kenya, AAHI has more than 20 years' experience working with communities in conflict and post-conflict situations, including refugees, internally displaced people, and host communities. AAH Zambia program was launched in 2001, initially to manage a refugee management program supported by UNHCR in Kala and Mwange Camps in northern Zambia. The program, which ran for 10 years, benefited over 45,000 refugees, mainly from Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC. In a quest to learn more on the Action Africa Help Zambia program, let's explore together.
Action Africa Help Zambia is part of the bigger family of Action Africa Help International, whose headquarters is in Nairobi. Basically, as an organization, we are working with the lively challenged communities to ensure that they improve their livelihoods. As Action Africa Help Zambia, we are operating in three provinces. We are in Lusaka, where we're implementing the Lusaka Urban Project for the refugees. We are also working in Kaoma with the refugees in Mayukayukwa, as well as in Solwezi in Maheba. Furthermore, we are also in Lwakula province in Kawambwa, where we are working with the rural communities around Mushota and other rural areas within Kawambwa district. What is it that we want to see with the communities that we are working with? First of all, we want to take this opportunity to sincerely thank the government of Zambia, firstly, for having an open door policy towards refugees who are one of our beneficiaries, and also for providing an enabling operative environment for Action Africa Help and other development organizations that are working, especially those that are working in the rural communities. What we want to see as Action Africa Help in working with these rural communities is to uplift their livelihoods. But we also do realize that some of the areas we are operating are quite far away from Lusaka, where most organizations may not necessarily want to go and operate in those areas. One, for various reasons. One, there are no social amenities. Secondly, the high costs related to implementing activities in such areas like Kawambwa, for example, are quite high. You may not be aware, for example, that in Kawambwa, with the withdrawal of World Vision, Action Africa Help Zambia is the only organization that is operating in the area. And given the vastness of the district, later on the province, Lwakula province, to have very few organizations working in rural communities has been a very huge challenge in terms of the outreach of beneficiaries. So you find that in Kawambwa, Action Africa Help's work is on high demand, but our spread can only be matched with the available resources.
AAH Zambia further expanded its programming, working with both refugees and host communities to implement environment, HIV and AIDS, and maternal health activities, particularly in Kawambwa district in Lwakula province, through the Community-Led Prevention Initiative, COPI, project supported by Positive Action Children Fund, PACF.
According to the strategic plan for Kawambwa for 2011 to 2015, the prevalence rate is 8.2%, and the incidence rate is 14%. And then according to the e-mapping system for National AIDS Council, the prevalence rate is 7.10%. And that shows already that we might decline from 8.2%. Working with Action Africa Help has been one of the positive things, looking at the situation that we have for the response, the HIV/AIDS response in the district, which is multisectoral. We actually work with all sectors, and organizations are also part of the multisectoral response. And so putting them on board has been one of the most positive things. And one of the activities that they've been participating in the district are the elimination of HIV, or elimination of mother-to-child transmission. And we've also been doing condom distribution in the district. And we've also been doing voluntary counseling and testing. Then we've also been doing sexual and reproductive health messages. And for Action Africa Help, they've actually been doing those activities that I just mentioned in the five catchment areas, which are the operational areas for the district. One of the challenges that we are facing in the district is lack of local funds, because in the districts, that's where a lot of operations are going on and that's where people are. So if funders could consider funding organizations locally in the district, it would actually help in our operations.
School authorities are key stakeholders in making sure that underage marriage and teenage pregnancies are minimized in Kawambwa.
Here in Chibote, we have got we are facing a lot of problems, more especially pregnancies. Younger girls become pregnant due to maybe lack of facilities around here in Chibote. We find that most of them, those who are under 15, 16, they are pregnant. Some, they are from grade 5, 6 and 7, and very few in 8 and 9. Because of, if we look around, there is no much activities which is going on. And most of them, they find themselves engaging themselves in playing around with men and boys, of which to deal it. The end is usually to become pregnant. We have tried, we have some sports like football, netball at times, but you know, when the area is behind, the very few respond to that. Yeah. So maybe we would like to appeal those who may come up, come ahead and help us. I think different sports, different activities which can take place around here. Because if you look around, it's only maybe here at the mission, which is the place which makes them to be busy. But all around, it's like dominant. So if only we can have more things which comes in, then maybe even the pregnancies also will reduce. If one is still behind, is no that knowledge of knowing the importance of education, we find that once you come out to try to educate them, they feel that maybe you just want their children not to get married, but you just to be you know, without to be at a school, yeah. But we are trying our best to educate them and to help the girls especially. Like we have an example of one girl who was pregnant in grade 5. And she's 15. Yeah. So we tried to call the parents and talk to them. Though we tried to call the boy, it's not really a boy, but a man who is married with the children, but he refused. And when the case went back home, they couldn't do anything. They said, since the man has refused, so what can we do?
Ine, naipa ukulu mtu wa nchite. Nishindi mu grade 9. Nishindi 18 years. Naipa ukulu, nishimu October sinala mkulemba exam. Na kwenye mpo kwa mbo kuisa kusikulu, nefumo. Nti unalemba mu grade 9 na isa pasa. Lewa fiashu bandiba ishibati ninguwa tefumo. Bali safuwa, mwakaripa sana. Fuba shirenje bati ule yakuriyo wino kupere fumo olupanga ndo fumepo paka ofuna ile nokuya emukai funa bire nokuikala na bena bonse te walaikala te walaikala so ofuna ishte yakuya ku school ya shire kumana baisa ndatine na la college nde kushopano pene panganda funa sabati tumwasha shani pano panganda fyakudia funa fikuri ba mambeno Lainnya yang kasar asal ni, fnashi dia kusapo, jauh ini, mbuikshen kuskul. Pakut mulai aku skul na ini, mbuikshen kuskul. So fnashi dia kalau tinja aku mbuikshen kuskul. Na esa aku tu kuba fiasi, kubebat. Nende fok aku mbuikshen kuskul daddy, masa kana tinja aku mbuikshen kuskul, kita aku skul ya hari pita. Aku fnashi dia buih, aku jauh bena mampir fmu. Ati ini, na bangkan ino. Kabia fikuri ya umeneo baku kubwa kiseshe kusikulu. Bali saa kana tinete ati nkubwa kiseshe kusikulu mpia tashamoneke. Ninde ya kusikulu futi na iwe ule ya kusikulu. Pekofu na ashiri ya kusapo. Nungwamba fisana na kupisana panga ndawe. Fua ashiri mpia na mpia ati na ubu kile kusikulu. Funa ashiri ya sana panupele na fua ni kusikulu. Na isa amba nungwamba. Isubiwa ni nkwa atapantu muna alipita muma problem za yengi. So teach DVD in kama ide DVD na kwa tefu mafuti na leke school. Haa, upanda kumbwa.
Kwenye, naipele fu, nishindi pa school. Heo naipele fu, nishindi pa school. Bari ingitile kumilani.
Nishori mgrade shani?
Nishindi mgrade ten.
Mukashana li mgrade shani?
Mukashana li mgrade nine.
Yuhu wali nemiaka inga?
Na inemiaka 19.
Nge, na mukashana?
Hali na 16.
Soro baisa kuita?
Fiba shiringi tangu mna, fiba shireba timu, atiuretuwe, fiba shirempinguru pia.
Nivani wakupinguire, kusukuru na nguo kupa fiashiba mwana.
Kupa fiashiba mwana kesi, fio, fio bampinguru pia, numba. Afute fio bampinguru pia roa. Chini ingembio kumshupu kwa kufanya. Ero na alipa skuru. Na wafiashi. Baya wafuropa kumuna ndo kwa bati. Bari ilisha nyukumuna ndo kwa bati. Bari. Bari wanawiri orupi oru ingi. Ero na ashiri kuskuru. So chari kia ngoserako.
The project has continued to focus on reduction of deaths of women of reproductive age and infant mortality as a result of HIV using EMTCT strategies that have been proven to reduce the risk of mother-to-infant transmission as a gateway for HIV prevention, treatment, care and support services to the family.
We help people in areas of water and sanitation where we feel the sanitation of that community is not good. We apply for donor funding and we help the community to overcome that problem. We also do the HIV/AIDS program where we feel the prevalence rate of HIV is quite high. We get data from our district health office who give us that data from various catchment areas where they operate from. So in that case, we also contribute in the reduction of HIV new infections in the communities.
Where are there people, there are challenges? What are some of the challenges that you face?
And some of the challenges that we face as an organization in Kawambwa is that we lack transport. At the moment, we just use a motorbike. Go around the five catchment areas that we are operating from. At the same time, we also face challenges of bicycle transport for our volunteers that we work with as Action Africa Help Zambia. We also have a challenge of in communication, because the areas that we operate from, communication is very difficult in terms of roads and phones. The network is very poor because sometimes we contact our volunteers by phone, but since network is very poor, we're unable sometimes to do that.
The government is keen to see that such projects are supported.
At the start of the 2000s, the Republic of Zambia, in conjunction with the United Nations High Commission for Refugees, had set up a refugee camp at Kala, 24 kilometers from Kawamba Boma. This was a very big settlement, hosting about 40,000 population of refugees. So UNHCR and some other stakeholder organizations which were providing various services for the refugee population. Action Africa Health was responsible for providing health services. They were running a hospital within the camp which used to cater for the refugee population, and also for the Zambian population which used to live around the Kala camp. In the late 2000s, about 2009, Kala camp closed. UNHCR decided to wind up its operations. So several of their stakeholder organizations decided also to close services. But amongst those that decided to stay and offer their services to the Zambian communities within Kawambwa was Action Africa Health. So they've continued providing HIV AIDS services. They are a very key stakeholder on our district HIV AIDS task force because of the so many interventions they are doing in various communities within our district. Apart from that, they are also engaged in safe motherhood services, such as prevention of mother-to-child transmission, which they are doing on a large scale. And these services have been very, very well received by the communities. So we are happy as the face of government here in Kawambwa, because the people have shown a lot of appreciation. We have collaborated very closely with the Kawambwa office of Action Africa Health, primarily because of the good services that are being offered. So we are a bit saddened because now the feelers that are coming in are that the Kawambwa office is going to close. The program has come to the end of its lifespan, but the people are still clamoring for these services. So we have listened to the cries of the people and we've taken a step to write to the funding organization for this program to request that they extend the lifespan of this project so that our people can continue accessing these services. It is our view that if we extend the lifespan of the program that AAH is doing, then they can fill the void that will be left by World Vision Zambia Chama ADP. Why? It is because already AAH is extending its services in areas outside the coverage of World Vision Zambia, but they are also willing to venture into the ADP and continue with some of those services which will be discontinued under World Vision. So we hope that their funding agency will respond favorably so that we can continue with this collaboration.
It is a well-known factor that all government departments have their limitations, the health sector included. Under the district community medical office, we have a lot of constraints in terms of human resources, financial resources, and these hamper some of the programs that are supposed to be done. So these two stakeholder organizations have been to a great extent complementing the efforts of government. And if these services are withdrawn, then we shall have a constraint where sometimes we shall be failing to do some activities.
In 2012, AAH Zambia started managing an urban refugee program based in Lusaka, which provides basic services to refugees and asylum seekers with particular focus on vulnerable groups such as the chronically ill, elderly, single mothers, unaccompanied and separated children, and the disabled, SGBV survivors, and people living with HIV and AIDS.
As I stated earlier, the decision to wind up eventually will have to be made by their funding agency, because they are the ones that are making these resources available.
Through the COPI project, AAH Zambia is implementing an HIV and AIDS initiative to support women and children. The objectives of this project are to increase women of childbearing age who test for HIV and AIDS and get their results, to increase the number of male partners supporting their spouses in the use of family planning and other elimination of mother-to-child transmission EMTCT services, women attending antenatal care ANC clinic in the first 3 months of pregnancy, number of HIV-positive women accessing family planning services. Let's work together and live a better life today, tomorrow, and years to come.